In today's video, we're gonna walk through a sample workflow for converting a PDF document that contains math into a more accessible version. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's step into the ring. All right, first things first, we have a sample document here that has some math in it. And we have like a varying degree of accuracy, but right now the figure tags are coming through pretty terribly. And we're going to launch my favorite editor right now, and that is Snip.Mathpix. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna upload a file right into this editor. And so to do that, we're going to, let's open up the folder that I have the file in. Hold on, let me find it. And we're just gonna drop this in there. Now we have file name, we have page ranges, we can choose the section numbers, equation numbering. I think in this example, we'll remove the equation numbering, and let's select upload. All right, so it now uploaded, and I can select the file, and it has it over here in the PDF editor, and it's currently saying a conversion in progress. All right, here's the document, and we now have like the data split up. So let's see if we can view this in a different way. Let's convert it to a note, and that's going to allow us to make changes to the document. So right now we have the ability to enter LaTeX, and so that's what this is. We have the LaTeX description here for these equations. We even have the ability to have some chemistry equations in there. And this is super useful for us to edit the document. Now what we can do is we can insert handwritten equations, we could insert handwritten diagrams, or we can go into the editor mode, which is kind of cool. And let's go ahead and export the file. So we're going to export the PDF with LaTeX. And we have fonts that we can choose from. I'll go ahead and just leave the defaults for now. And then we're gonna select export. Now let's open up our file. Well, I don't want it in the browser. Let's open it in Acrobat. And let's just review this. So right now we've got no tags available. That's unfortunate, but it does appear that the math is at least in there semi-accessibly. Let's go ahead and do prepare for accessibility and automatically tag it. And let's just see what happens. So apparently this is a PDF with LaTeX in it. I'm very hesitant. It does have some paths in there, but interesting that some of the equations are actually coming through really well other than the path object. Let's right click the figure tag, select properties, and there's no alt text in here. So we're not out of the woods yet, but at least we got something there. Let's go back to the editor and let's see if we can export as like a different file type. So we can do DOCX. We could also do PDF with HTML. Let's see if we can do DOCX. We're gonna leave the font. Let's just leave everything the same and download this. And let's open up the Word doc. Wow, and it properly converted everything over in the Word doc as well. So it looks like our equations are in a prime position to be modified to wherever we want, wanting to take them. All right, but we still don't have the problem solved of what we're gonna do with these tags in here that are not tagged. So my thought is we're gonna want to do the LaTeX description as the alt text for the figure tag. So I'm gonna pull up another tool. Let's take our snipping tool and let's grab that content. Actually, you know what? I need to use the Mathpix snipping tool. Here we go. All right, now I can do a new snip and we're gonna take that same math problem because all I'm trying to do is get our options here. So we have different forms of LaTeX in here and these are different things that we can do to basically use the information. So we have MathML, we've got SVG that we can choose from. We've got the original equation. There's also a problem solver, which is crazy, but we're just gonna take this regular LaTeX right here. And what we're gonna do is right click the figure tag, select properties, and we can put in this alt text for images there. And that is one method that we can do to make sure that is tagged appropriately. Now, there's been a lot of discussion on using formula tags, so we can play with that. Let's right click, select properties, and let's change this to a formula tag and select close. Let's save the file. And I'm just curious. Let's run the accessibility checker on this. We've got alt text, figure missing alt text. Let me go back up to the tags. So it's not telling me that the formula needs alt text. That's interesting. And that's maybe because the text is mostly live, though it doesn't look super scripted to me. So there is still some issue with the equation itself. But as of right now, this is a decent starting point for us to get math in here accessibly. I don't know which version is necessarily gonna be faster. I'd like to see the Mathpix tool actually export properly. But from what I can tell, this at least gives us a starting point. So if I wanted to, I could have come in here and grabbed the LaTeX code as well. to use for our alternate text. So that concludes today's super quick video on how to convert a PDF that contains math using Mathpix. And then we explored a couple of ideas on how to prepare the alternate text for the image inside of the PDF. One other thing that I wanted to test was to see if we can get spoken math as the alt text. So I'm going to take this equation, I'm gonna copy it, and let's throw it into Perplexity. I'm going to say, can you generate spoken math for this equation? And right here we have negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. This isn't like perfect, but it's something. So let's launch back into the PDF. And so in this example, we could right click the figure tag, select properties, and we could add that description instead for the alternate text. It just sort of depends. If you want to find out how I can help you get accessible, or if you want to join my exclusive community, check out the link in the description of this video. And as always, I can be your champion for inclusion. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.